Okay, today the class is on homeostasis. The class totally is on homeostasis and feedback mechanism. Okay, homeostasis and feedback mechanism. Today's class, I am Dattatreya Mukherjee from Jinan University. So let's know what is homeostasis. Homeostasis is a process by which the body wants to make up its abnormality. Like sometimes oxygen gets higher, sometimes carbon dioxide gets high in the body, and the body mechanism always try to make up the whole process. This is homeostasis. Let's take an example. Okay, like suppose this is a chart of body temperature. Let us 37 is the normal body temperature. This is a normal body temperature, okay, but this is not the body temperature, even not normal, always in 37. It's sometimes going to 37.2, sometimes going to 36.9, like that. But if it is going to above 37.2, that is beyond normal range, like this, the body will try to make it 37 or in the normal range, or it is if it go to 30, then the body will try to make it 37, like that. This is the process. This process is called homeostasis. So homeostasis is a process in which the body tries to make up its abnormality. If body can't do, then it is a disease condition, then we have to give medicine or outside environment to make it homeostasis. So homeostasis then induced is worked by the external environment. Now the thing is, you have to there is two process of homeostasis, that is feedback mechanism. Okay, there is two feedback mechanism. One is positive feedback mechanism, another is negative feedback mechanism. So what is positive feedback mechanism and what is negative? Negative is the most important. Okay, negative is the most important mechanism in the body, negative mechanism. So negative feedback mechanism is most important. Like if oxygen, take a look in the negative feedback mechanism. Take a look. Like suppose oxygen concentration go high in the body. Okay. Now the control system will start, the process of homeostasis will start, and the body will decrease the oxygen in the body. This is a negative homeostasis. Like that, carbon dioxide get high in the body, body temperature get high in the body, all these things can get high in the body, and all the things like oxygen, carbon dioxide, body temperature, all these things get high in the body. So all these things get load. Okay, it get low by the mechanism of negative feedback mechanism. Understand? And what is positive feedback mechanism? There is like coagulation. Like this is a artery which is ruptured. Now the coagulating factors are coming and bounding it. And the coagulating factors is increasing and increasing and increasing. It is in coagulating factors are increasing. Coagulating factors are increasing. Okay. Then it is positive mechanism and it makes a thick things on the ruptured part of the artery. So this is positive feedback. Suppose if it is negative feedback, then what will occur? This is the ruptured part of the artery, coagulating factor coming, but sometimes it is decreasing. Then what will occur? Then this thick part will not form and the coagulating process will be hampered and the coagulating process will be very much bad like this. Now another example of positive feedback, like parturition. But parturition and labor. Okay, this is a important process. So in the parturition, what occurs? The cervix become dilated, uterus become contracted. Okay. If uterus become the contracted, and the cervix become dilated. So this is a positive feedback. The what? If it is negative feedback, then after some time, the cervix will start contraction, uterus will start dilation. Then this is the baby will not come out. So this have to be a positive feedback, not a negative feedback. And another these things, and now I'm getting this is a positive feedback. Coagulation is a positive feedback. Another is voltage gated sodium plus channel. These all are positive feedback. Okay, so now we have understand homeostasis, positive feedback and negative feedback. So summary, what is homeostasis? Homeostasis is a procedure by which the body wants to make up the abnormality. Okay, the abnormality can be caused by disease or some extracellular changing material. Okay, so if the homeostasis can't occur in the body, then we have to give outside medicines or other products from outside to make the homeostasis, to control the homeostasis. And homeostasis is done by two mechanism, that is called feedback mechanism. One is positive feedback mechanism, one is negative feedback mechanism. Okay, positive feedback mechanism is the mechanism where we have to increase the product to gain the homeostasis, to gain the equilibrium environment, or to gain the normal range. Or in negative homeostasis, we have to reduce the amount to gain the homeostasis condition. Okay, thank you. I hope this is effective for you. I am also a student of medical science, so I teach you in a simple way how I understand. Thank you.